not for all lectures perhaps, but for essential part of this lecture. I do not care about how F depends. For any U, it's smooth vector field, but I do not care on the nature of U capital, and it is just index set. So it's just family parameterized by some index. And for so general setting, in so general setting, the control functions, I recall that control functions are functions U of T, functions U of that send of dot T U of T with values in U. And for so general setting, we can use only piecewise constant function. Piecewise constant function are always available. So controls for us will be piecewise constant, essentially. It's very important. Number of pieces and length of pieces are not fixed. You can select whatever you want. So in principle, if you have, say, continuous dependence on U, you may approximate rather well any functions. Yes, it is not. It is bad from the point of view of linear functional analysis. This is a strange set of functions, but quite okay here. And if you study controllability issue, that's what I'm going to do, it's quite enough. Results for these functions will be the same if we consider some good dependence of U and much bigger functions, so L infinity, as in general people say. It will be just the same story. And as maybe see, of course, for optimal control, perhaps the next lecture will be dedicated for optimal control. You cannot do anything in this setting simply because if you try to minimize some costs, minimizing sequence, and your piecewise constant functions are not converged to piecewise constant function. You cannot find optimal control in this class, usually. Okay? So that we will need some more. Essentially, continuous dependent assumption of U will be sufficient. Okay, but for controllability, now it's just family of vector fields. And it's good to think of family of vector fields. So we plug in it here, and we get a trajectory. We start from some initial points. Q of 0 equals Q 0. And we have this our, what we call, endpoint map, which send U of dot into Q of T U of dot, where this satisfies the Cauchy problem, solution, unique solution of Cauchy problem. So in fact, it's how it's done. You have several dynamical systems. You go some time along one system, then switch to other, switch to third, and you select your switches, whatever you want, in any order, in any segment. So that's a setting. And we consider attainable sets, A, say, Q0. Maybe it seems to me that tomorrow maybe I was not very precise in formulation of my theorem. K of T is simply points. So we start from Q0 here, and we have some, they are going to be in this setting piecewise smooth trajectories. And we get some set using a lot of, we may select very sophisticated control switching in particular way. And we get all these guys are called. And Kriener theorem, which I saw formulated, actually was for other set. So when we do not fix the exact time. It's the same story, but Q of tau U of dot, where 0 to Renner serum I formulated, I recall it now. And of course, very similar result can be stated also for T fixed, but condition a little bit stronger. Later I discuss it and maybe leave its exercise. Conditions for fixed T. It's almost the same. But it must be stronger if you would like to. So the theorem. Firstly, I defined Li Q0 of Fu of this family. This is just linear hull of all Li brackets, iterated Li brackets, span, let me write span. Span. Fu1, Fuk of Q0. Okay. What I say in this situation, the theorem says, theorem, for any positive T, I assume that this Li Q0 Fu, this is some subspace in the tangent space. Values of Li brackets of vector fields are vector fields. The values at Q0 are tangent vectors to M at Q0. And this is some subspace, in general, some subspace. Assume that if Li Q0 F is the whole space, people say that our system is bracket generating, then interior, I can write just like this, then A Q0 smaller than T is contained in the closure of interior. And in particular, interior is not empty. In the closure of interior of AQ0 and T. Not empty, and any point in the attainable set can be reached from the interior. Okay. So, and I start a proof. Proof. It is, in my opinion, it is a Kriener theorem. It's due to Kriener. I think it's a simple and elegant observation. Okay, so I start. First of all, it is sufficient to prove, let me explain that it is sufficient to prove that we reduce to the following situation. The main thing to prove, main property to prove, is like that. So that Q0 is contained in the closure. It's sufficient to show that in initial position is contained in the closure. In the closure of int A Q0 smaller than T. And that is what is written here, it's for any T, for any positive T, arbitrary small. Indeed, look why it is like that. Why it is like that. Assume that we know that this is Q0, and we have attainable set. Structure may be, it may very singular be here, but always full dimensional, that's what we are proving. Could be a kind of cusp. Could be the whole neighborhood, but could be a kind of cusp also. Assume that we already know that, and assume that we can reach some Q that belongs belongs to, that is far from Q0, belongs to A. First, we may do it for, it's the same for do it for smaller than t or for smaller or equal than t because smaller or equal than t is just a closure of exactly smaller. I'm sorry. Q0 not, does not belong. In my picture, Q0 does not belong to the interior. Q0 belongs to the closure of the interior. All story about the closure. And since this guy is this guy for anity, it's equivalent to say that it is like that also. Because up to closure, they are the same. That one for less, because our trajectories are smooth continuous, piecewise smooth continuous. Up to closure, it is the same. fine, this is for anity, you know, for any, for very small t. Can take in even, yes, epsilon. Now assume that for time smaller than t, we can reach point Q. Q belongs to A of smaller than t, Q0. And so we can reach it. So there is a trajectory. I don't know how it goes. Certainly it goes inside this set because it's admissible. There is some trajectory which comes here, okay? Then, look. But what is a crucial point about control system? Control system, you could think about control system a priori if you would like to generalize and forget all non unnecessary structure. You can think it about how differential equation. So you consider you have some restriction, velocity at any point belongs to some subset. You cannot go too far in this setting. It's very important that this is a family of smooth vector fields. Why? And we always do like that in controllability. If to have a working efficient theory, we need the following fact. We need the following fact, that if control is fixed, as soon as control is fixed, we do not have only a trajectory. And yesterday, formal calculation, I also used it. But we have the whole flow. We have the flow. We have a family of diffeomorphism, which send any initial point somewhere, and it is quite good, smooth with respect to initial data. It is in our setting is piecewise smooth with respect to t and smooth with respect to initial data. It translate everything ahead. And that's it. What we do? If we have one trajectory which come here, then we have the whole flow that come here. And we do the following. We for very small time, we know that we can reach this guy by some sophisticated switching. We can have this neighborhood, including Q0 for small time. And then we apply the flow for prescribed time. This belongs to some tau, where tau smaller than t. And we go a little bit bigger time, because first we apply the small epsilon time, and then we get the whole neighborhood. And then we apply the flow. And flow is just change of variables. It's transform. And the result will be, okay, maybe write it more precisely. So assume that Q is a Q1, say this Q1, is a Q of tau U tilde of dot, of particular control, okay? And we consider the f- flow pt that send q of 0 into q of t in virtue of differential equation. Okay? In virtue of this differential equation. Then I claim that then P so this is diffeomorphism. Diffm. Wants to diffm. I need a choke. Belongs to M. Then I claim that P to of A epsilon of A Q0 of epsilon, small epsilon if you want, is contained automatically in A Q0 of tau plus epsilon, okay? That is automatic because I can change the switching as I want. First time epsilon I do to realize this guy, and then transform all this set by prescribed control by U tilde. We can also call it tilde if you want, because control is U tilde. So that is automatic, and that's all, because now our Q1 is the closure. It's clearly the closure, it belongs to the closure of this set. So real question is about very small time, and is it true that we can find interior point of attainable set arbitrarily close to Q0? Okay. And here the main very simple and nice argument that I try to explain. That it's one of that argument that when you write everything precisely, you need too many symbols, too many indices. But argument very simple. I try to do it by words and pictures to make it very clear, but it's indeed very clear. What we do, so it's a kind of induction procedure. Moreover, as you see, we will show more. We will show actually more than this fact, something more important. let me, and it's convenient now to define it's actually legal to define solution of a time invariant equation, so that autonomous equation Q dot Fu, where U is fixed, is constant of Q, flow generated by this equation, I denote by ETF. ETF is a diffeomorphism, it's MM. Like in the case when F is a linear vector fields in Rn, it is exactly matrix exponential, nothing else. But it has good properties. It's good idea to define it like that, to denote it like that. It's one parametric subgroup. And here ATF, TF send say Q of S into QT plus S to show that it is indeed one parametric subgroup. U, absolutely, yes. Thank you very much. But it's general notation for any vector field. By now, case it is, we have index U. So it's convenient to do like that. So let us start our induction. First step. There exists a vector field, so we assume the bracket generating condition. First step, there exists a U, Fu, such that Fu1 say, there exists u1 in u such that fu1 of q0 is not zero. If all of them are zero, then all brackets are also zero. We do not have bracket generating condition. We can also say, because we generalize it to higher dimensionless, that if all of them are zero, then all of them are tangent zero-dimensional submanifold at the point q0. And we know that this, if vector fields are tangent some submanifold, then also bracket tangent is some. We generalize it, it is just a starting point. So there is at least something, it's not equilibrium for all. Okay, fine, take a trajectory. И say t fu1. This trajectory, small piece of trajectory, arbitrary small piece of the trajectory, the blackboard, so it is small. I draw it like this, but it is supposed to be small. E t fu1. Then it is one-dimensional submanifold. It is a smooth one-dimensional submanifold. I claim that there exists a point. For us it's important to go ahead. We take it for t positive t. Positive and small t. Okay? Positive this q0, positive and small t. It's one-dimensional submanifold. So if our original manifold was one-dimensional, we are done. It has interior point. If not, then we know that there is a point, there is some vector field in our family that is not tangent to the submanifold everywhere, even for small pieces. There is a point Q, this is say T1, such that and the vector field Fu2, such that this is a point ET of Q0, T1 of Q0, such that this point vector field is linearly independent. If this vector field is linearly independent, let us cook two-dimensional submanifold considering the map, say, how to call it, S1, S2, QZ, E, S2, F2, FU2, E, S1, FU1 of Q0, okay? Where we take, since, look, what we have here. If we compute derivative of this map with respect to with respect to S1 at this point, where S2 is zero, we have another field here. The derivative of this map with respect to, call it phi 2, say. The d phi over d S1 clearly at point T1, 0, T1 in this point, is of course FU1 evaluated at this point. And D over DS2 of phi at the same point is of course FU2. We call this point Q1, for example, of Q1. So they are linearly independent. These two fields are linear, these two derivatives are linearly independent. So if you consider image of phi on the small neighborhood of this point, not small neighborhood of zero, but in small neighborhood of point T1, zero, this is an immersion because it has non-degenerate derivative. Okay? This guy are linearly independent. It's immersion. So we get a two-dimensional manifold. Two-dimensional manifold near our point. So it's arbitrarily close because we could start from arbitrary small segment here, arbitrary to Q0. So we have a two-dimensional piece of two-dimensional submanifold near our point. Absolutely, absolutely. That's a picture that often happens. No, starting point, no, because we always go ahead. We do not assume any symmetricity. We cannot go back. Very soon I explain that if we can also go back, that it is, then we have complete controllability. But if you go only ahead, or not in general, of course, there could be, yes. No one field is zero, and all could be lead in the same, more or less in similar direction, close, but, and then you cannot return, okay? Again, this I also explain. Okay, so we have this two-dimensional piece of manifold, and again, if our original manifold was two-dimensional, we are done. If it is not two-dimensional, we continue the same story. There exists a third field. There is some point in this two-dimensional submanifold, and a third field which is linearly independent. We cook a three-dimensional submanifold and continue. So it looks very, and it works, it is a result. But now think about it a little bit more detailed. That's important what I say now. Because actually starting from this third step, the situation a little bit different. So I was not really cheating, but it's good to see that apparent contradiction, which is not contradiction. So then assume that it is so general that the set U, that you cannot have just one element U capital, but two elements is fine. For generic couple of vector fields, it has bracket generating property. If you take any couple of vector fields and perturb them a little bit in C infinity topology, it becomes bracket generating. So, and okay, if we have just two vector fields, then FU3 must be one of these two. So we take FU3. But at this point, the trick is, and it looks like a contradiction. Our argument is totally correct. But at this point, at FU3, of course, linearly dependent of, if you have just two vector fields, one of them. But the point is the tangent space to this submanifold is not linear half of F1, F2. At the starting point, it is like that, but if you differentiate this for S tangent, so here we build this map S1, S2, and tangent space to the submanifold is just linear half span of d phi over ds1, d phi over ds2, okay? But the point is that differential of this map with respect to s1 is not fu1. If you compute this differential when s2 freezes u2, zero, nothing here, and differentiate with respect to S1, then it is S1. Otherwise, the differential of d phi phi over ds2 is, of course, fu2, but differential of d phi over ds1 is es2 f2 star applied to f1, okay? And corresponding point. This is not F1 anymore. But this is a tangent to our submanifold, and we can find field which is transversal at some point, and build the phi 3 of F1 S2. S3, S3, F3, FU3 и S2, FU2, S1, FU1. And according to our construction, to our choice, this will be immersion, so derivative with respect to S1, S2, S3 are linearly independent. Even in the case of just two-element set, here we have again U1. But derivative with respect to S1 is not F1. So that's the picture, and so this is the end of the proof. We may continue and so on. And look that actually we have more, and this is important, more than the fact that we have non-empty interior near Q0, because to prove that we have non-empty interior, we used actually implicit function theorem. We built a diffeomorphism that sends some family of controls. Some family of controls with by the way, just we need only n pieces. We know that with n pieces of n-piece controls, we obtain the map. We see that what we prove, what we proved, we have proved. Let us analyze it. Let us analyze it. We proved that we found a family of controls U S of dot, where S is belongs to Rn, S1, Sn. N is a dimension of our manifold. It's also sometimes useful. That number of pieces is just the dimension of the manifold. And such that the map, the endpoint map, F, such that such that the endpoint map better to say the map which sent S1 Sn into Q at the point sum of Si Us of dot, call this phi, such that this map has a regular point in the positive ortand arbitrarily close to zero, okay? It has a regular points arbitrarily close to zero. So that's very important. Somehow endpoint map, any point, or at least for in this setting, almost any point in the image of the endpoint map has a regular pre-image. It's much more than to say that map is open at some point. It has a regular pre-image, okay? It's a smooth map. By the way, already here you see that this family we constructed, for our map it is perfect. If we compute solution, we have a smooth map. But from the point of view of the classical functional analysis, it is not so good. Because when you move switching points, it is not so nice. If you work in the space of functions, of controller space of functions, some Banach spaces with some LP topology. You do not have smoothness here, it's not smooth. Okay, so that's the end of the proof. Now corollary. Assume that we can go forward and back. F of u equals minus fu. We can go in both directions, forward and back. Then and we have a bracket generating condition. Bracket generating condition. So ли for all points. Let me do it now for all points, because I would like to have a global corollary. Q f u is t q m. Then I claim that A, call it A infinity. Maybe we do it locally. First we do it locally. Just take one point and then global result as obvious corollary. Then Q0 is contained in the interior. What people say that we have a local controllability. It could be manifold of very big dimension. It could be interior. See, I did not finish it. I wrote of smaller than epsilon Q0. So the many, it could be just two vector fields, as I mentioned, and manifold of arbitrary dimension. If we are bracket generating, actually it means that we can go immediately in any direction, we want. But for that, it is essential. Then we'll try to weaken this property that we are symmetric. And this is quite easy. And moreover, again, actually we have more, and this is important. This is important that we have more. Actually, the Q0 has a regular preimage. Of the endpoint map. Okay. Look, Q0 any interesting system, Q0 is of course belongs to the critical level of the endpoint map, because it's a critical, because if we then I show. But it has regular preimage, arbitrary close to zero. And then this is the main idea of all controllability result, actually. In the preimage of this, we can choose control, arbitrary close, time to orbit close to zero, at piecewise constant control. Yes, it's such that we come in our points and we perturb switching, then differential of this map, which just perturb switching, is full dimensional. Here we need 2n switch. Again, we can estimate number of switching. Here we have 2n switching. And it is again extremely simple. Again, only thing we need that as soon as we have control, we have also not one trajectory, but diffeomorphism. This is extremely simple. Let me show it. So indeed, okay. So we may, since we are symmetric, let us consider system. We can reverse time. If we go back, we are still admissible. A Lonel trajectory, because if we reverse time, we can consider system Q dot equals minus f of u. It is the same as to go in the opposite time. So in the opposite time. Okay. Due to symmetricity. What I mean? It's again better to explain by words and draw pictures. We have a Q0, okay? And we know due to bracket generating family, from bracket generating property, that we have interior good points here. Regular points here. Interior and that achieve as regular point of the endpoint map. But okay. But now do it for system that we can do. But if our system is bracket generating, this even without symmetricity property, this is also bracket generating, of course. So if we go backward, we obtain some a priori some good points again. Okay. Some good points again. And then what we do? We obtain some good points. No, maybe no, it's backward. At this moment, backward is not so important. Go forward, we obtain interior points. Take one of the interior points and some particular control, u tilde of dot, which goes to this good interior points, regular point. and this Q is, say, phi, we constructed this phi of S1 some Sn. And tilde, very particular. Mm-hmm. So that is a exponential of some Sn tilde f u n S1 tilde f u1 of q0. Okay? Denote this diffeomorphism. Forgetting Q0, putting any argument, denote it P tilde. Everywhere tilde, this is a diffeomorphism. This is P tilde, this is diffeomorphism M to M. Okay? And consider composition of the map. First you go, and since now, for the moment, we did not use that the set of vector fields is symmetric. But since it is symmetric, then also P tilde of minus one can be realized by P tilde minus one is minus S1 tilde FU1 minus SN tilde fun, okay? So it is also can be realized by moving along admissible controls due to symmetricity, because we know that these vector fields are presented, also presented. So look, and then what we obtain? We obtain that the Q0 belongs to the interior and has regular preimage. Belongs to the interior of the map of then we obtain the, we consider the map P star minus one phi of S1 Sn. Where S1 Sn belongs to our neighborhood in the first ortand. One Sn. Okay. Composition of this map. So first we go to some point changing S2, varying S1, SN, then we freeze them, put them tilde, which lead one of those which lead to this one. We freeze them and apply, go backward because it is now allowed. Okay, we consider such a map. Such a map, S1, SN. S1, SN is a variables here and a fixed here. But P is applied, is worked. P is a diffeomorphism. This is diffeomorphism. So this is these points, just diffeomorphism, change of variables. And it transforms neighborhood around this point Q tilde, around point Q tilde, into neighborhood of Q0. Okay? If you consider this map for S1, Sn equal S tilde, it is just identity. We don't move, okay? For S1, Sn equal S1, S tilde, this is we come to point Q0. And if you compute differential of this map at the point of S1, of S1 and Sn, that this differential is non-degenerate because it's a chain rule. It's a differential of phi, product with differential of diffeomorphism, which does not depend on S1 Sn. This diffeomorphism does not depend on S1. So we got neighborhood of Q0. Moreover, we get it in a good way as a regular image. Okay. So now it's nothing to do to globalize this result. If this property is satisfied at any point, then and manifold, of course, is connected. If it's not connected, we certainly cannot jump from one connected component to another. Then we can go whenever we want from any point. We have our manifold. We have two points, Q0, Q1. On the manifold, and we can, as usually, we connect them. Since we are connected, we connect them by some curves. Maybe not admissible. It's not admissible curves, just a connected property. And then at any point, we can find a neighborhood where we can reach any neighborhood, and this it means that we may find a way, maybe very sophisticated way, to step by step to go from Q0 to Q1. Time may be long. Now this corollary is for short time we have a small neighborhood, but in corollary. Is at that setting, so we are bracket generating and symmetric. And if we are symmetric, Li Q Fu is the whole TQM for any Q, and Fu equals minus Fu, then A, say infinity, Q0 for arbitrary time, is the whole manifold for any Q0. Is we have complete controllability. People say that is complete controllability. Now, if we analyze the proof, you also have, and this is important for applications to mixing, things like that, this is really important. We have more. I always insisted that we have emphasized that we have this regular way to reach whatever we want. If we analyze this, the proof we have, moreover, not only for symmetric situation, but for any situation. So that is sufficient condition to build completely controllable. But let me formulate proposition proposition assume that fu is bracket generating an all point, bracket generating. And assume that we have controllability. A q0 of infinity. In particular, in the symmetric situation, it is like that. Then I claim that if we perturb little bit in C0 topology of field FU, in C0 topology, that may be surprising, we still keep controllability. In general, we do not keep bracket generator problem, but we still keep controllability. Because it is like that. If you realize your point as a regular value of a function, when you perturb little bit vector fields, then in F0, so new fields is again smooth, but close only in F0. Then your map is close in F0. And it covers the neighborhood, small perturbation, this application of Brouwer fixed point C, it still covers the neighborhood. It may happen that it have critical points because we approximate only in F0, but it is covered. So this is a C0 controllability, C0 stable property. So if we have controllability, we say that we have a solid controllability, small perturbation does not destroy. In C0, do not destroy it. Another remark that assume that which another very nice property of controllability. It happens that in this setting, in finite dimension, but symmetric still rather restrictive. So I would like, symmetric, at least one sufficient condition for controllability we have, but symmetry is rather restrictive. Still, our argument gives something for any controllable system, and quite soon I will try to give conditions for non-symmetric systems that are still globally controllable. But assume that we have global controllability. Another proposition or corollary, is like that. Assume that we are bracket generating and proposition. Again, FU is bracket generating and all points generating. And also we have approximate controllability. Closure of IQ0 at infinity for arbitrary time is the whole space. Bracket generating plus approximate controllability. I claim that then we have exact controllability and in this very stable manner. Then we have this equivalence that what never happens in infinite dimension. If we would like to use finite dimensional control and our manifold is infinite dimensional, then there are no chance to get exact controllability, but we can, by approximation to by finite dimensional objects, we can often, it is absolutely non-trivial with some analytic technique, reach approximate controllability. But in finite dimensional, it's important that it is just equivalent. Equivalent, of course, if we have bracket generating. Bracket generating is not, before explaining why it is true, one, it is true. I also say that for approximate controllability, bracket generating property is not, of course, necessary. If you have a approximate controllability, you may have, if you have just one vector field and minus this vector field. If you take a torus and the rational winding of the torus, just one vector field, just one, you don't need even minus, irrational winding of the torus at any trajectory is everywhere dense, so you approximately go whenever you want for big time. So, but as soon as we have a couple of vector fields and bracket generating property, it cannot be just approximate, but automatically exact in the stable way. So, but the arguments essentially the same, very similar to what we did in symmetric situation. So we okay. We would like to get Q0 from, we would like to get Q1 from Q0. There is Q0, then we have Q1. Okay. Let us consider system starting at Q0 with opposite time. Now I do not assume symmetricity. Opposite time is a different system, but still bracket generating, of course, because bracket generator is a linear property. consider the system Q dot equal minus Fu, minus Fu of Q. Okay. So we have some trajectory which lead. We do not have some trajectory which lead here. We just wish this. We have Q0, we have Q1. Go guy with opposite time. We do it in Q1 with opposite time. We do it in Q1. Guy with opposite time. Okay. So what here is our assumption. Our assumption this proposition. Now assumption that closure of attainable set from Q0 is a whole manifold. Okay. In this point, we have a very good map. We have interior, the whole neighborhood of very good points. Okay. That was our first statement. In particular, since attainable set from Q0 is everywhere dense, we certainly can reach one of these points. One of these very good points in the interior of an attainable set for reverse system. For reverse system, okay? Here we take reverse system at Q1, and since we have bracket generating property, we have very good points on the reverse system. And fine. And that's all. Since it is reversed, when we go from here with the positive time, we just move this neighborhood in a regular way. But for controllability, you don't need even that. So since it is in this point is again, we have an open neighborhood of points reachable by reverse time. When I go backward. Since attainable set from Q0 is everywhere dense, we can catch one of these points with positive time from Q0. Then go from positive time, change time again, and we come to Q1. Because that was for reverse system. So we have this. And if you look about it in more details, maybe add one more piece, then again you have this property. Ah, okay, but this we already proved in general. So we have complete controllability, then we have, means that we have complete controllability is a stable map. So that what does bracket generating property in finite dimension. But now, now I would like to work with a non-symmetric situation because it's important. In natural system, we have some dynamics, some drift, which does not depend on our will, and may control by control, we just perturb it somehow. So what, how to manage this situation? First, observation that we can always, the idea is like that. So we have our vector fields, family of vector fields, and we will try to add more vector fields such that closure of attainable set does not change. Related, compatible with this one. And if at the end we arrive to the symmetric situation, then we have controllability. This is a basic idea. And first observation, which is a corollary of very general relaxation procedure, is if we have FU, if we consider convexification of FU, if it is controllable, then also FU is controllable. Something like that, if we have three fields, say, bracket generating, like that. It is not symmetric, but convexification is symmetric, and we are still controllable. So this is a actually follows from the general relaxation procedure that I would like to explain in the way that you can apply not only to controllability, because it's important and quite universal property of the endpoint map, actually. I explain it like that. But to see why it happens, it's not so hard. So if you have two vector fields, it's quite natural. If you have two vector fields, so we go along one vector field, we have a flow like that. Along another vector field, we have flow like that. And now if we switch very fast from one to another, we start from Q0, switch very fast from one to another, then we approximate convex combination of trajectories, just switch from one. It's a typical relaxation procedure. So it is rather clear, but that point is good to formulate mathematically important general result. Because if you do it well, you see that it is then maybe applied also for PDEs, it somehow gives you Gromov's convex integration. Let us do it. For that, yeah, I come back to endpoint map. Well, analysis of the endpoint map. So we wrote. We can write now ODE for flow. Now we consider some very general, not even control system, but just our word is, I even do like that, XT of Q, where XT is a time variant vector field. And we have a map that can be written in the operator form as linear equation. So if we take P. What? Yes, just no, this guy appears when you plug in control. But a result I would like to give, general result, I would like to explain, deals just with non-autonomous, as when we consider the expansion of the endpoint map. Because what is control? We have just some universal map that associate to any non-time-varying vector field a flow that send time-varying vector field into the flow. And the control endpoint map is just specification it. For any control function, it's just composition of two maps. First, for control function, we associate an time-varying map, and this first step is trivial. It's a point y. If you have u, in control system, if you have q dot equals fu of q, we have actually first step is take u of dot into fu of dot, u of t into fu of t, even it is pointwise, very simple map. And then we take this non-time-varying vector field and apply universal map. Main properties, information are in this universal map. The control is just specification to particular family of time-varying vector fields. So, if we now consider PT, the map which sent Q of zero into Q of T, this is a diffeomorphism inverted of this equation, then we can write this equation like that. Equation in operator form, and then PT, we can treat PTX, we can treat as a change of a variables operator for scalar function. If we have A now function, just real function, and M, PT applied to M for us is A PT. Linear operator on the space of function. Vector fields is also linear operator on the space of function that we know. Directional derivative. This is change of variables, that's directional derivative. Then we can write our system like that. P dot, we did it, but you can check again, xt. It's Cauchy problem, like on the system on the group. Left invariant system of the group of diffeomorphism, if you want. P zero is just identity. P zero is identity. We don't move. So let us rewrite it as integral equation. So we can rewrite it now as PT equals I as operators. Since the linear operator, I can write sums, whatever you want, I get other operators. From zero to T, P to X to. So this is the equation. Integration by parts, Leibniz rule, things like that are quite legal in this setting. We are in C-infinite, so there are C-infinite diffeomorphisms, C-infinite vector fields, C-infinite diffeomorphisms, and topology is a usual topology of uniform convergence on compact of derivatives up to certain order on compact subsets. So it's the Frische manifold. Okay, so a space, if all operators are space. So what I would like to, what I would like to show, then this map, we proved that this map that sent, we consider the map which sent x dot to p dot, we proved that it is smooth map. If we consider topology for non-various vector field, we consider topology like that. Norm of X, and no, not hard to deal with topology. Norm of X dot
is just integral norm with respect to T, integral norms with respect to T in the usual K, CK norm, CK norms with respect to X, okay? X dot is L1 with respect to G, but actually LP, any LP is fine here. L1 with respect to 1, we let us work, of course, of finite segment T from 0 to 1. Otherwise, we need more norms, more compacts, also compact segments. So XK, say, call it XK, XCK. Actually, we in fact proved, we used it for control system specification, but all calculations were for general non-autonomous vector fields. We proved that this map is smooth if you use such a topology of free shared space. And then they found the Taylor expansion more or less explicitly as operator, in the operator sense. Now, very important, and this is a relaxation property. That this phi is continuous, is much weaker topology. In topology with norms like that. Topology defined by the norms, with norms defined by the norms . So we do not take a norm and then integrate, but we first integrate with respect to T and then take the norm, okay? It's continuous in this topology, and this is very important because in such a topology, we may, that approximation of perfect in such a topology, if you jump from one value to another very fast, then in average, approach just combination, because it's a linear story, it's not ODE anymore, it's not differential equation. That average approach, it's a weak topology somehow. If you switch very fast, average approach linear combination, okay? Approach linear combination. Convex combination, I'm sorry, convex combination. But what is interesting, and why I say that it is more can be applied also for PDE somehow, even if you have the PDE, and gives actually convex integration, if somebody heard about that, because it approach not only along trajectory, but the whole flow. I say that continuous is map which sent vector field to flow. So we switched very fast with respect to T, and we approximate in this way. If we do it in all points simultaneously, we approximate the flow in CK with two, all derivative, with K derivative in any compact, approximate arbitrarily well. So it's the level of flows that happens. So we have two kinds of variables here. Time and the initial condition for your ODE. And you approximate uniformly with respect to initial condition, convex combination, with all derivatives with respect to initial condition. Only uniformly, without, of course, any derivative with respect to T, but uniformly is all derivatives is in the
what converge is this guy, not values of xt, non-derivatives, but average converge. And trajectory converge uniformly, derivative not, of course. It is something like that, trajectory converge uniformly to convex combination, but uniformly with all derivative with respect to initial data. Now let us prove it, and then just two words how it then applied to PDE. And of course, it implies immediately that property that I taught. Any trajectory getting by convex combination can be uniformly approximated by original admissible trajectories. So if we have a controllability for convex combination, then we have approximate controllability for original, and we know that approximate controllability is equivalent to exact controllability. So we can this we already know. So we can consider always convex combination. And in operator setting, the proof is so obvious of this rather strong property. Let us prove it. Of course, some work is needed, but very simple functional analysis gives you that the integration by path is legal. Integration by path is legal. The only thing we have to do here is integration by path. Okay. Let us. What I'm going to prove now, would like to prove that if this converge to zero. Lemma. If this weak norm star, if we have a sequence which depends of n, if this star converges to zero, as n goes to infinity, then pt uniformly converge to identity. So that will be continuity with respect to our norms at identity. At zero for vector fields. Continuity. So I'm going to prove it, but I will not continue. I will not prove it for continuity at any point because it is reduced to this situation. You remember maybe in the previous lectures, I showed how to reduce by changing of variables, reduce study of endpoint map near arbitrary x, near arbitrary point to zero by changing of variables. So it's the next step, but it's very simple. So actually, since this guy is left invariant in the Lissio theory language, if it is left invariant, that it's sufficient to prove all the analytic properties of it at zero, at identity, and then just translate. A translation is fine. Translation is continuous in all possible topologies. And just done translate. That's what we did actually in the previous lecture. By hand, we translated it. So it's enough this. And this is integration by part. You write PTN equals, we integrate by part. We integrate this and differentiate this. Minus
minus, and here we have since we integrate this, so we have integral from 0 to tau x theta, so minus integral from 0 to t, p tau x tau. Because when I differentiate pt, I get btxt. It's integration by part. First integrated part, and then we differentiate pt, we get this one, and the integral of x tau. Okay. Just a minute. This one minus this one. This is integrated part. This one minus. Okay? It is just integration by part of this guy. First, we consider integral of p and integral of x. That's minus derivative of p and integral of x. And now look. Xn. Everywhere. And then this integral goes to 0 in CK norm. This integral goes to 0 in CK norm. And this diffeomorphism are limited. This if vector fields are limited, so we are bounded, the sequence is bounded, because if vector fields are bounded, then also PN are bounded, and this goes to 0. That's it. Okay, in the most general nonlinear system, finite dimensional, this is valid. And then you can translate it also to any point property. So it's indeed like that. And we can always take convexification. So we start with some family of vector fields, can be discrete. We take convexification, but bracket generating is a starting point. Bracket generating can be discrete. Then we take convexification. Look, if convexification not necessarily symmetric, but at least contains some neighborhood of zero, symmetric, we go back and forward, then we are completely controllable. But if not, because our application are like that. We have a system Q dot equal. So main applications are Q dot equals Fu of Q, where Fu is a F0 plus sum of Ui Fi. So we have a nominal dynamic somehow, and Ui are just real numbers. Normally for Ui, we expect that they take both signs. Otherwise, we simply change F0. So we have a kind of, and they can be bounded. Yeah. So we have Q0, we have this F0, we have some piece of low dimensional, but at least one dimensional of admissible controls. And that F0, it's already convex. So with convexification, you can achieve anything. But still, very often it is controllable, if not for small. Normally, if F0 is strong, as is written, if F0 is not zero at a point, then I do not have much time. I have to do what to do for next. Okay, but something I say now. if F0 is not zero, then at least for small time, for sure, all velocities are contained in the in the acute cone, and we cannot cover the neighborhood for sure. If we draw the wall, we do not intersect this wall for small time, because all velocities will go to one side of the wall. Okay. But for bigger time, in principle, we can. There are two very interesting possibilities to study. Local controllability in the case when near equilibrium of F0. Very interesting and deep theory exists when we try to check, somehow test problem, check controllability, test also for fine optimal control theory. Because optimal control, that the next lecture explain it, is very similar to controllability somehow, and to local controllability. And when we have equilibrium, assume that F0, FQ0 is zero. But just equilibrium, because this is important dynamic. It may be, it's some dynamic which taken from mathematical physics, so it could be Navier-Stokes equation, no, some reduction, Galerkin approximation of Navier-Stokes equation via finite dimension, and whatever you, some finite dimensional dynamics that can be approximate also infinite dimensional PDEs. And it has equilibrium. But they're isolated, this equilibrium is isolated. It is not like it's everywhere zero. So at equilibrium, we have symmetricity, but symmetricity in one point is not enough, not at all. When we, at Q0 admissible velocities is like that, but then they start to be like that, then they start to be like that. Very interesting and is fantastic effects is the study to characterization of, we are bracket generating, but not symmetric actually, not symmetric. And when we still can go in any direction from here. Or that's equivalent to reach the equilibrium for any direction. Some kind of local stability property of control. Can we stabilize our system using this perturbation, okay? The, equilibrium may be not stable, but you have some way with small c even to control it, but only but the dimension of control is small, is much smaller than that. It may be just one. It can be just one plus u f epsilon u smaller than c. That's very interesting problem. When it's controllable, when not, you can somehow segregate brackets. So bracket generating gives you only full dimensional attainable set, but it starts to be important by what kind of bracket you reach this full dimensional. Some brackets are good, some bad. It is a deep story. It was well developed in 90s essentially. 80s, 90s, but then somehow stopped because exhausted somehow. But there are still interesting open questions, almost forgotten. I hope that the technique developed that it's a test problem, a kind of sport problem to characterize, say, if you have two vector fields like that, equilibrium to characterize in terms of bracket, when it is locally controllable, when it can go whatever you want, and when not. It is test problem, but technique developed has much more general meaning, of course. There is a, okay. But another story, if it is not like that, if we are not in the equilibrium, that we do not have a chance to to get local controllability, but still quite often may get global controllability. Now assume that this F0 And F0, you know, somehow not unique in this setting, because you can always, we have affine space piece of affine space, affine ball, or affine box of admissible velocities. So of course, as F0, we can take any guy inside. In principle, we can take any guy inside. Change F0. But assume that F0 is conservative. Q dot equals F0 of Q is conservative in the following sense. The manifold can be compact or non-compact, then we have this invariant compact K, big compact K, such that exponential of TF of K of K belongs equals to K, just invariant con equals to K. And it is preserved volume, if the system is preserved volume. So divergence of F is zero. In this sense, I mean conservative. Then vector field minus F0 is compatible. Then vector field, so my time is over, maybe very, because it is not a big deal to explain proof. It's more or less the same argument, but maybe I just explained by words. So then in this case, the system is controllable. Divergence. Then the system fu equals f0 plus ui fi is completely controllable. Somehow what you do, you prove that you can go approximate trajectories of minus F0, points of trajectories of minus F0, for big time, controllable, of course, for arbitrary time, for arbitrary time. Attainable set at an infinite time is the whole space. So this is a corollary of our first Kreener idea, a Kreener result with non-zero, about non-zero interior, and the Poincaré theory. For such a system, as we know, the trajectories inside K, if you take such a system, then and take any neighborhood here, any neighborhood O, and apply ET F to O, then they exist always T such that this is a which it's the guy moves and it can back. Any neighborhood intersect with itself. So this is a Poincaré, famous Poincaré results, one of the deep results which is trivial proof. Essentially because because volume is preserved, volume of compact is finite, and you cannot cover everything by non-intersecting, by infinite number of non-intersecting domains. You use also group properties, but I do not have time to repeat it, even if it takes 3 minutes to prove this Poincaré recurrence property. And if you have this property, again, we use mainly the same argument as before. The same argument of before. We would like to show that vector field minus F0 is compatible, so we can approximate, if we take trajectory, this is ET F0 of Q, starting from Q, and we would like to show that we can approximate it this by go back, the trajectory is like that, go back going in positive time, but using also controls. And how we do it? Again, we consider since if we are bracket generating, there is a open set. It is important that we can reach some open set near Q0. Near Q0, okay? And we can reach open set near any. So it is like that. So we can reach our trajectory of F0 come back. It's always intersect any neighborhood of such a point. We take a point with reverse time, with negative time, and we know that if we take a small neighborhood of it and apply just vector field F0, then we appear again in the same neighborhood. But now what we do? We consider, so this is Q0, this is E minus T0, say, F0 of Q0. It's a reverse time. But then with our system, again, with our system with reverse time, we can find attainable set, some neighborhood that is attained. And if this neighborhood starts to travel by F0 in positive time, then it is intersect itself at some moment. Okay, so we take an interior point of attainable set from this one, from minus ET0 F0 of Q0. And then apply just F0, but in positive. It's attained, this neighborhood is attained, that we apply F0 just for positive time, and any neighborhood is intersect itself in future, unavoidably, this is Poincaré property. So we appear here, and it is arbitrarily close to this point. All everything is done arbitrarily close to this point. So we go approximately in negative direction. Minus F0 is available, and convexification is symmetric. If we put here plus minus F0, convexification is already symmetric. So that's the argument. Since we have full dimension, we can also do that. But of course, it is like a Poincaré result, not theoretically nice, but not really applicable, because you know that neighborhoods are very small, and we should wait too long to get this controllability. Still it is important, because it's a kind of existence theorem. If you have control, if we have I'm finishing. If we have a fine system with conservative drift, this called drift, this controllable path, with conservative drift, bracket generating, then it is completely controllable for very big time. Fine. It means that we can really get any point from any other, and then we can start optimal control, but it is an important existence criteria, because if there exists some path connecting two guys, and they exist optimal, also time optimal. And this is a great achievement, because time optimal satisfies usually in calculus of variation, critical points of something satisfies some differential equation, and we already know, so I'm on that, not so long, guys. No, there is one that for sure, one, so we resolve much more restrictive problem that connect Q0 with Q1. This existence of some path give existence of optimal, and it's already a lot. So thank you very much. I'm sorry for long.